The Kwe National Development Plan sets the nation's long-term development priorities. It's organized around 7 pillars or areas of focus for investment and improvement. Healthcare. Improve service quality in the public healthcare system and develop national capabilities at a reasonable cost.
Sheikh Jabir Al-Ahmed's Hospital. His Highness Emir Sheikh Sabah Al-Ahmed Al-Jabra Sabah attended and patronized the opening of Sheikh Jabir Al-Ahmed Hospital. His Highness Emir was received at the venue of the celebration by the Ministry of Health, Sheikh Dr. Basil Hamoud Al-Sabah, and senior officials at the Ministry of Health. The ceremony was attended by His Highness the Crown Prince Sheikh Nawaf Al-Ahmed Al-Jabra Sabah, Speaker of the National Assembly Mirzoug Ali Al-Ghanem, His Highness the Prime Minister Sheikh Jabir Al-Mubarak Al-Hamad Al-Sabah, and senior officials of the state. Delivering his speech at the event, Minister of Health Sheikh Dr. Basil Al-Sabah said that the opening of Sheikh Jabir Al-Ahmed Hospital was a historic event in Kuwait's healthcare history. The Sheikh Jabir Al-Ahmed Hospital went through various challenges and phases. However, with the strong directives by His Highness Emir and the tremendous efforts by all those who were involved in the construction, the dream was brought into reality, said the minister. The main building of the hospital consists of 5 towering 10-story structures built on a 220,000 square meters area, said the minister, adding that the total area in which the whole project was constructed on stretched to around 725,000 square meters. Sheikh Dr. Basil Al-Sabah said that the hospital bed capacity reached around 1,168 with 36 operation rooms, a medical center, a helipad, and a parking lot accommodating some 5,000 vehicles. The opening of Sheikh Jabir Al-Ahmed Hospital adds another milestone in the Kuwaiti leadership's development vision, affirmed Sheikh Sabah, who thanked His Highness the Emir for all of his efforts. On his part, Health Minister Undersecretary Dr. Mustafa Rida said that the hospital would add to the bed capacity of medical facilities in Kuwait to reach over 160,000. The opening of the hospital is a step in the right direction, affirmed Dr. Rida, who noted that Sheikh Jabir Al-Ahmed Hospital was an integral part in the ministry's plan to take medical care to the next level in Kuwait. After the conclusion of the speeches, a documentary depicting the different stages of construction was screened for the attendees. On the sidelines of the hospital's opening, Executive Director of Sheikh Jabir Al-Ahmed Hospital and Head of Mubarak Al-Kabir's Health District, Dr. Saud Al-Dara, said that outpatient clinics and basic medical services, such as radiology, labs, and nuclear medicine, will be available for the masses next week.
Jabir Al-Ahmed Al-Jabra Sabah Hospital is the largest hospital in the Middle East and the 6th in the world in terms of space and capacity. Now we will take you on a social media tour regarding Jabir Al-Ahmed Al-Jabra Sabah Hospital. From Twitter, Al-Safat newspaper quoted Al-Qabas, Jabir Al-Ahmed Al-Jabra Sabah Hospital in the custody of the Ministry of Health within days. And from the breaking news, Ministry of Works coordinates with Ministry of Health to receive Jabir Hospital. Finally, from a Siyasa news account in Twitter, Ministry of Works said the delivery mechanism of Jabir Al-Ahmed Al-Jabra Sabah Hospital to Ministry of Health within a month. For more information or details regarding Jabir Al-Ahmed Al-Jabra Sabah Hospital, please visit the website of Ministry of Works, www.mpw.gov.kw.
The United United Nations High Commission for Refugees hosted an honoring ceremony that was sponsored by the Deputy Prime Minister and Minister of Foreign Affairs, Sheikh Sabah Al-Khalid Al-Hamad Al-Sabah. The event was dedicated to honor the General Director of the Kuwait Fund for Arab Economic Development, Mr. Abdulwahab Al-Badr.
Participate in this today evening, the ceremony of honoring Mr. Abdulwahab Al-Badr, the Director General of Kuwait Fund for Arab Development, for Arab Economic Development. This actually event shows the appreciation of the UN system by the United Nations High Commissioner for Refugees by honoring His Excellency Mr. Al-Badr, who is representing the Kuwait, the state of Kuwait, on their humanitarian leadership. We all know that Kuwait was honored by the Secretary General 3 years back as the global humanitarian leadership, and we are all together here working together in supporting the refugees, the IDPs, the temporary contractual laborers to support the national agenda in providing humanitarian assistance for people in need.
I'm really truly honored to be here tonight as the UN High Commissioner. High Commission for Refugees honors Ustaz Badr of the Kuwait Fund. Kuwait has played an enormous role under the vision and leadership of His Highness the Emir, as you know, one of the great humanitarian leaders of the world, and especially in the area of helping the those Syrians who have had the great misfortune.
What we witnessed today was a decoration or a ceremony to honor the work of the Kuwait Fund for Arabic Development and its chairman, its director, Abdulwahab Al-Badr. This is by the United Nations High Commissioner for Refugees here in Kuwait. This is a ceremony, an award, an honor that is very well received, very well founded. The work that the Kuwait Fund is doing internationally, be it in humanitarian aid or be it in development aid, is actually exemplary. We are very proud to cooperate with the Kuwait Fund in projects abroad. We want to intensify the cooperation.
During the ceremony, a short film was played that demonstrated Kuwait's Fund for Arab Economic Development alongside the UNHCR in providing aid to the Syrian refugees in northern Iraq. Officials of international organizations and ambassadors acknowledged Kuwait's role in providing aid to those needing help.